Hi friends, in the previous video we have seen about the extending interfaces and also interfaces as a function types, right? Now we will see some other optional things we can do. We can also pass optional parameters and also optional properties in the interface. Okay, so how we can implement optional parameters and optional interface, how we can implement this? So here, for example, here in the interface iName, I have an output name. So for example, let's assume that I need to implement output name also. So you can mention this one as a string. Okay, so now immediately the person everything will get error. Why? Because I need to implement this output name. So but this output name is not compulsory in my person class. So it's an only optional parameter. So in order to represent this one optional parameter, we can represent this one as question mark. Question mark means, so you may represent this one or otherwise you may not. So now this person didn't give error. Okay, now for example, I will remove and also here in this constructor I can also represent the optional parameter in this one. So for example, I want to mention this age as an optional parameter. Okay, if I want to mention this age as a parameter, optional parameter, I can use this question mark here. Okay, I can use this question mark. If I use this question mark here, immediately we got an error that age is compulsory. Okay, age is compulsory if it is represented. Why? Because here age is compulsory in the interface. So now I can represent this one also as a parameter, so that now in this class person, so age is not a mandatory. Now here there is no need for me to pass this one. Okay, there is no need for me to pass this one. Okay, now if I didn't pass this one, so now we will check that here and here in the phrase what we can do is, so for John let's check, and also for what we can say for Leela also we'll check. So for Leela I am not passing any age, and for John I am passing the age. Now here in the hello we will check that if this dot age is there. Okay, if this dot age is there, I will console dot log in such a way that, okay, I will console dot log in such a way that phrase this dot name, and also I will do the plus thing, my age is or something like this. So in order to know whether age is printing or not, and I will do this dot age. Okay, and else if it is not present, I will just console.log and I will just console.log the, what I can say, without age I will print. I can remove this all the code. Okay, so now here age is not compulsory in this class, and also in interface also age is not compulsory. So that is the reason I mentioned here. And if you see here console.log phrase, if the age is present, I am printing this one. And so now for Leela I am not sending any age, and here I am sending. So now what I will try to do is Leela dot hello. Okay, and I will send the phrase hello for both the guys. I will send the hello only. Now let's check the output. If we check the output here, we got, see, hello Leela for this one, and hello John, my age is 20. So depending on this one age, we got the phrases. So that means here if age is present, we are displaying this one. If it is not present, we are displaying this one. So now here age we didn't kept it as a mandatory concept. So this is how if we want to represent optional parameters in the interface and both in the class, you can use question mark before this one. Okay, for the methods also, if you want methods as optional parameters, you can mention the question mark, same concept. And another one what we can do is, if you want in here in this hello phrase also, you can also keep this as a question mark. Okay, or otherwise if you don't want like this, means so this one is nothing but equal to this one. Okay, the same thing. So but here we have mentioned public something like that, so that is the reason we are getting error. So you can mention this one, or is equal to like that also you can mention. So in the year 6 we have learned, right, this one. So in this way we can send the optional parameters in the through the interface, or also in the classes, and also in the methods. So we can represent optional parameters. If you want to represent optional parameters, you can use the question mark, this one. Okay, so this is the optional parameters and the properties how we can represent. Now let's see how this code will be compiled into the JavaScript. Okay, so if you see here, we are having so many interfaces. We are having interface add function, we are having interface iName, and we are also having interface iPerson. So three interfaces are there: add function, iName, and iPerson. So how this iPerson, iName, and add function will be compiled into the JavaScript? Let's see the example. So if I go, this one is a main.ts, right? If I go into the main.js, so this is the code how it is compiled. If you see here, there is no name such that with iName or add function, or another one is something what we can say is iName, iPerson. These all things are not there. Why here we have iName, iPerson, and add function is there, but in the main.js there is no such type of things. We have, so it has created a add function, and here it has created a where function, constructor function is declared, and also the functions is declared in this one. And also we have all the functions, all the methods, what are responsible for the person, we have it is declared here, and it has created a object for this one, and it is, so it is simple plain JavaScript code what we have learned in the JavaScript constructor functions, how we can represent this one. Like this it was represented, it is a simple JavaScript code it was. So that means in JavaScript we don't have the concepts of interface. Just for the development purpose, in TypeScript provides an option, provides a feature for the development purpose, interface is implemented. But in the JavaScript there is no such concept like interface in the JavaScript. Okay, so TypeScript has the feature of interface, so that in the development for writing the cleaner code and all those things, we will be implementing the interfaces in the TypeScript. For only in the development purpose you will be getting an errors, and if you do no emit on error is equal to false, automatically if there is error in interface also, automatically the JavaScript will be compiled and JavaScript will be generated. Okay, this is all about the interfaces concept in the TypeScript. Okay, so if you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comment below to this video, and also if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.